I'd like to tell you a story that I think will help you along your path.
Proceed.
Early in my life, before I was a Valkyrie, I was a healer in a small village. My father trained me in the use of herbs and natural remedies. To him, coming from a long line of herbal healers, that was the only true medicine. But visiting the city, I saw healers who used magic. Only magic. To treat their patients. I'd seen it work. And work wonders. I tried to tell my father, but he said mage healing was against his philosophy. A dangerous shortcut that violated tradition. Being a good daughter, I respected his convictions. But that all changed when he took ill. That's a good place to stop for now. When you're further along on your journey, I'll share the next part of my story. A master fights not only to survive, but to grow with every encounter.
Back to my story.
And they say you can't buy self-improvement.
You are fighting your way deeper into Valhalla.
Sigrun, it's good to see you back.
Freya was just being cautious. I'm right as rain. How fares your journey?
We have uncovered our host. It is Tyr.
Tyr, you say?
Aye. And no projection either.
I never knew his connection to Valhalla was so strong. But then, he goes back further than I do. Fascinating.
Kratos, I'm glad to see you're back inside. It seems Valhalla has arranged something special for you in the throne room. See you again soon, Kratos.
Find you! Incoming!
You remember this, Kratos. The memory is vivid. A familiar scene to any that know your legend. A man at the crossroads of a fateful decision.
Aye, you've spoken of this, brother. The pact you made with Ares, to stave off the barbarian horde.
The day I sold my soul to a god of war. Why show me this?
Well, if I had to guess, probably to make you feel like the piece of shit you are.
Is he necessary?
He's no part of my design. He's either Valhalla's or yours.
At least he hasn't replaced me again. Not yet, anyway. Seems a real charmer. A memory fragment of your time in Alfheim, then.
Tell me, who was Kratos of Sparta the day you made your pledge to Ares?
I was the youngest captain in the Spartan army. I had gained a reputation for my skills in combat, my command of the battlefield, but also my aggression. I was determined to never lose, and until then, never had. My men were loyal. Fiercely so.
How many Spartans did you command?
Not enough that day.
How many barbarians did you face?
Thousands.
Something's lost, but something's gained here.
Dear, why help prepare me to take your old position? Why not fulfill it yourself? Seem capable.
To the mortals of these realms, I am an ancient.
Apologies for interjecting, Tyr. We're moving to a new area.
Don't give it another thought.
Last night!
Right side, brother.
Yeah.
Targets on the battlefield there. Another Ehalya to the left. I think Valhalla's burden is satisfied. Right then, time to ascend to the next area. If you're ready.
By this point, you've certainly earned your pick of self-improvements. Shall we make a bargain?
I'll tell you more of my story now, if you care to hear it. Back to my story.
Hamlet Progress, right there.
Valhalla selects your opponents for a reason. Embrace the challenge, but know you can prevail.
Before you ask, yes, I was back in my old forest again. And this time I encountered my former boss, King Oberon. Rather eye-opening, actually. I used to be a true believer for him. Would have done anything he asked. But now I see through all that charisma and feigned wisdom down to the small hypocritical tyrant I know him to be. Wait till I tell you what he put me up to regarding a particular magical flower. Well, this is an unusual little corner of Valhalla, isn't it? Shall we see what else we can find in here? I think we're meant to choose one chest or the other. Shall we have a look?
You wish to tell a story of your first master?
Aye. Seems to be the very story Valhalla has me reliving, in fact. Oberon fancied himself a romantic, you see. Always claimed that love was more important to him than anything. One time, he led his entire entourage on a journey to attend the wedding of some duke or other, near your old neck of the woods. The groom, this lordly prick, had conquered a warrior queen and was marrying her as part of terms for peace. And this somehow was so romantic to Oberon that he dragged us across the sea to pay respects. Never mind, he was quarreling with his own queen the entire way! Well, I'll have more of that one, to be sure. As I was saying about my old master and his lofty, so-called romantic ideals, we'd settled in a forest outside of Athens, a place well situated to observing the comings and goings of the Duke's other guests. There we observed the romantic complications of some local youths, and Oberon gets it into his head to intervene, bids me fetch him a magical flower that can manipulate the affections of others. Supposedly, the idea was...
There we will speak later.
Do what you need.
Get ready!
everywhere. Made it through the burden. Valhalla seems to appreciate that. I see the one you need to get there.
Be wary of that tail.
Valhalla keeps the score. Good. The route to the higher area ought to be open now.
Hello again, Kratos. I must say, it's genuinely hard to think of anything stupider than pledging your soul to Ares of all people. I mean, any of Zeus's brood are bound to be garbage, present company by no means excluded. But Ares made a real art out of being vicious and depraved. Though, I suppose I can't begrudge you your role model. I see you still use the blades he gave you. Can you really say you regret a decision? And still keep benefiting from the trappings of that decision? I'm not sure, I'm just asking. You ever try to do the math on how many people died as a result of your little collaboration? Like contemplating the grains of sand on a beach, isn't it? Just overwhelming, honestly.
is that?
Looks like someone left you a party favor. Oh, and it's a symbolic totem of your shame.
That's so thoughtful.
Ah, now you've done it. You're being judged. And we all know your past actions wouldn't pass muster with anybody. Oh, I meant to ask. How did you like setting yourself on fire? Truly entertaining stuff. Sorry to miss how it ended up. I think maybe you still have some ash on your skin. Am I crazy? Decisions, decisions. A siren? Cover my ears! Kratos! I suppose Valhalla's impressed with that kill. It's the fair version of a Piraeus level. Horns, the horns! Behind you, watch out!
getting bigger, are you?
Get to it! Behind you, idiot!
I suspect it's high time to parley with Valhalla about improving conditions for us inside.